This is a guide to using Cheat Engine in Dark Souls 3. Cheat Engine is a useful tool for creating new builds without having to grind hours of PvE. A reminder, Cheat Engine should be used for convenience only. Don't use Cheat Engine to give yourself an unfair advantage over other players. Can you be banned for using Cheat Engine? Possibly. Nothing I show you in this video will get you banned, except for one major exception, which I will cover. With that out of the way, let's get started. You'll need a couple things to get started. First, you'll need Cheat Engine. I've linked a clean Cheat Engine download in the description, courtesy of inuNorii from the Grand Archive's Discord server. Download and extract it to where you want. Next, you'll need a table. I've linked the GitHub in the description below, also courtesy of inuNorii. You'll want to download and extract this zip file. With Dark Souls 3 open, we're going to do the following. Open Cheat Engine and attach it to Dark Souls 3. Open your Cheat Engine table. This can be done at any point, it does not need to be done immediately. Note that although my game is offline due to server issues at the time of filming, you do not need to be offline in order to use scripts that are safe. In fact, using scripts that can ban you while you are offline can still cause you to be banned when you return online. Next, we're going to start a character. Starting class is the one thing you can't change with Cheat Engine, so make sure you choose the right one. Pick Knight if you don't know what to choose, or follow the flowchart that I've linked below, courtesy of the Cryptid Tracker. Pick up the Ashen Flask ahead of you, taking care of the two hollows. This is all the PvE that you will have to do. The first script we will use is BonfireWarp, to warp to Firelink Shrine. This script can be used to warp to any bonfire in the game, unlocked or not. Fun fact is that we do not need the coiled sword in order to be able to embed it into the shrine bonfire, which is how we were able to get away with skipping Gundyr. The next script that I want to cover is ItemGib, as it is the most important script you will be using. I want to emphasize this now. If you have both DLCs, everything you drop is safe. If you do not have both DLCs, do not give yourself spells from DLCs you do not own. You can consult this handy flowchart that I made. I use Lightning Arrow as an example, but it applies to any and all DLC spells. Attuning the spell is technically what flags the anti-cheat, but avoid giving yourself the spells in the first place just to be on the safe side. Now let's give ourselves a few items. Say I want to focus my build on Leto's Great Hammer. The newest table is very smart. It won't let me infuse it, as it cannot be infused. It also does not let me upgrade above my character's weapon level. What do I mean by character's weapon level? Dark Souls 3 tracks the highest upgraded weapon you've ever had. You cannot change this with Cheat Engine, so let's make sure to get it right. Say we want a PvP at 125. I'll need a plus 10 weapon, or in this case, a plus 5 special weapon. I'm going to do a couple things. I'm going to use the Upgrades Need No Materials script, because I don't have any Titanite. This script does not remove the soul cost for upgrades, so let's use AddSoul to give myself a million souls. Now that I have everything, I could walk over to Andre, like a peasant, and upgrade my weapons. But instead, I'm going to use the NPC menus to upgrade my weapons with him to save me the trip. I can do this for other NPCs, such as Rosaria, if I need to change my stats or my appearance, or the bonfire, if I want to access my storage box or tune spells. Now that I've upgraded my weapon to the highest level that I will need, from this point on, I can simply give myself weapons at that level. I will never have to upgrade weapons again. While the scripts I've shown you will cover 99% of creating a new build, I'll show you a few more that I use regularly. Even though I have plenty of souls, I can use no-cost level up to make my level ups free. I can use Mass Item Gib under the Item Gib menu to give myself all items of a certain category, again being careful to not give myself DLC spells from DLCs that I do not own. I can set my Estus level to 10, and then click Reinforce Estus until I have max Estus. I can also unlock all gestures. If you've made it this far into the video, I really appreciate it. I just wanted to speak on a popular cheat engine alternative called Honest Merchant. If you were just here for the tutorial and don't care about this, feel free to close the video here. I want to start off by saying that the mod is actually pretty good. It was super easy to install and use, and I'm not trying to disparage the work that Churchguard put into it in any way. but what you're seeing right now is that I've given myself a task to create a level 125 character with fully upgraded weapons in Estus, as well as a set of rings and armor. As you can see, we come in at just under 2 minutes with Cheat Engine, and close to 6 minutes 30 with Honest Merchant. You might be thinking that 4.5 minutes per character isn't a huge difference, and that it's still faster than doing everything legit. But here's the thing, we aren't done yet. We still need to get to where we want to PvP, whether that be Pontiff or elsewhere. That takes a couple seconds with Cheat Engine using BonfireWarp, but with Honest Merchant alone, we'd have to run through the PvE all the way to Pontiff and further if we want to PvP elsewhere. Even being high level and having fully upgraded weapons, it's still going to take a while. And every time I want to make a change to my build or add a new item, I have to go all the way back to Firelink Shrine. For these reasons, I think Cheat Engine is still superior to Honest Merchant. That's not to say there isn't a place for Honest Merchant. I think if you just need a handful of items on a completed character, it really makes no difference which you use. But for the vast majority of people, it's going to be worth it to learn how to use Cheat Engine.